So, what the fuck is this? You might be asking yourself. It's a tape machine, a pretty standard tape machine, except for all this business. It has been modified to have control over the tape speed by battery operated. And we're going to think of it as tape speed in this video. Sometimes it gets described as pitch. We're going to think of it as speed. So you have overall speed here, which is pretty high, pretty low, doesn't go all the way to zero, doesn't go to stopping, I kind of wish it did, but it still gives you a pretty big range. And then you can set cueable speeds with each of these. The button cues it, and the dial picks what speed you're cueing. So pretty simple, but it opens up a lot of possibilities. I think of it as kind of a tape speed playground. If you have a static chord or a static note just looping on a tape loop, then you can move it around. You can have kind of parallel chord progressions or create very simple melodies. And if you have something more complex like this tape loop, then things get kind of interesting and unpredictable. It's quite similar to the Ondas Magnétique, the OM1, but doesn't have the VCA. It doesn't open and close like a keyboard as you play each pitch. Alright, so I'm going to make a little sound with it, with this pedal. I really like how the Chroma Console sounds with this particular tape machine. And here it is. So that's already sounding pretty nice. The machine itself sounds good. It's not as noisy as a lot of these sorts of tape machines would be. You can hear a little bit when I turn this back up and bring the compression up a bit. You can hear a little bit of noise in there, but it's not too bad. It's not nearly as noisy as a lot of smaller machines tend to be, like this portable machine. It also has a more neutral tone. Sometimes I like the sort of scrappy tone of those smaller machines, but this one's a little more neutral. It still does sound like a small tape machine, but not as much as that little guy. It gives you control over volume. It has, I don't know what's going on with this whole situation with the USB, but I'm sure there's a manual online somewhere. And that's basically it. Pretty quick one here. I'm gonna do a bit more playing. Thanks for watching. I'm going to go to the next one.